Hey, man, what's going on down at Area 51?
Some of the giants down there are coming out of stasis.
You know, that kind of... Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
What I heard was that, this is first-hand knowledge through an email that's encrypted. We use a code. I'm going to have to write it all down because I almost can't remember how we do it.
Mm-hmm.
So, what they told me was that one that I told you about that's 18 foot tall,
mm-hmm.
I've talked about it a few times that I've seen it look like it in glass or ice. Well, the top of the I guess the thing holding it back cracked.
Yeah.
And fell off.
Ooh.
And showed about half of his head.
So you're saying that this giant is running around Area 51 now. What are they doing to subdue the thing?
Well, they're shooting at it and stuff, but I told them, you know, when I left, they knew about the copper bullets, and I'm sure they're not using them, because if they were, they would have handled this situation.
Mm-hmm.
It would have been over. See, if it would have been me, when I was security control over there, I would have busted him in the head with a copper bullet when that first piece cracked off.
Yeah, I would have too.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because, I mean, that's what they are. And they're cannibals. They eat people, you know. Some of them's feet are 36 inches long.
How many giants they got down there, Greg?
I would say at least 100. I mean, I never counted, but I was thinking about it. It would be about 80 or 100.
Are these left over from the flood, or where'd they come from?
Yeah, they come from the flood. Because everybody says, well, what happened? I have people asking, what happened to them when God flooded the earth? Well, they're spirits. You know, they were fallen angels. So they know everything. They know that their end is coming and all that. So when the flood was coming, they burrowed themselves deep into the ground. They don't like the water. But I guess in a certain way, I don't know this positive, but in my book, in a certain way, that they're bound to the water.
Hmm.
I don't think any of them have a land base except for like Dulce Area 51, Area 52. Area 52 is just southwest of Salt Lake City. You can probably look it up and find it.
Mm-hmm.
But they have a lot of crashes there. They never tell you what it is, but we know what it is.
How is Groom Lake and Area 51 connected?
Well, what it was when they made the first atomic bomb, they were flying around looking for a place that would be good to do it. This is the fact. And the scientist that was with them said, this is the place. And they bought up all that land. Okay. Area 51 is just a declassification center. And a classification center. I tell everybody that. Not much goes on there. Once in a while, you'll see something, maybe a little paranormal or something. But that's why they fly those people in there with no, they can't see out the windows or anything. Because all they do is declassify and classify information. They go through tons and tons of information a day. Thousands and thousands of pages. They're trained to classify it. Secret, classified, top secret, crypto top secret. And that's what they do there. Area S4 is outside of Area 51. It's just salt. It's like a salt flat. And it's got a hole in it. You can go on Google Earth and see it. The hole in the ground where they go in and out. But even the live version of it, they won't show you. You can't get it. But that's how they came up with S4. S4 is, the S stands for staging area. Yeah, staging area for what? I don't know. You know, it's just staging area. That's all it is. And that's where everything happened. That's where when I was there that I seen all this stuff. And the underground part where I was at, the entrance was in Area 54. And then you got on the train that's underground, the magnetic train that goes, I don't know, they say 3,000, I don't know about that, but it goes 1,000 at least. But
I want to know, is there any way to verify the giants running loose down at Area 51?
There is no way to verify anything that I say, Daniel. Mm-hmm. There's no way to verify any of it. Listen, people always want to know, what's it like that I wish somebody at Area 51 would talk, or somebody that knows about UFOs would talk, and then when you do, they discount you. You know, they want somebody to say it. They want me to come out and say it. But then they don't want to believe it after they hear it, because it is too scary. It's too scary.
Are there UFOs at Area 51? I guess the question is, do the giants drive these UFOs?
No. What? Those are demonic beings. They're spirits. They're the grandchildren of the Nephilim.
Mm-hmm.
And they do all these experiments. So they have wormholes that they go through. I don't know how they do it, really. I don't, but I've watched it. I've watched it happen. It's like a